We can keep on talking about the science of writing prose and poetry, but we must all, as practicing writers, admit that so much of scheming actually doesn't go while the process of writing. What happens is you are deeply inspired. Once again, the word inspired is a cliche, but you almost feel as if you will die if you don't write what is burning inside you. Now, you have to run an industry around the business of writing, so much of these kind of, you see, I have a very simplistic view about these things. Too much of science is being driven towards writing prose or writing poetry. Like, when I read T.S. Eliot, I am deeply confused whether I am writing, whether I am reading poetry, or I am reading prose, or I am reading theology. Similar thing happens maybe when I am reading Kundera, whether I am reading Nietzsche, or whether I am reading a story, or whether I am reading some kind of a anthropological forecast. So, and we have to all understand that the relationship of any book with the person concerned is deeply private and personal. So there has to be a space where you have to allow, in the postmodern times, a writer has to allow for the reader to participate in his book, in his or her book. And I think I'm very confident about this book that this book allows that kind of participation. I'll give you an example. Incomplete conversation set pieces suddenly finishes. Now, Sita told me, you have 4 more chapters. Why are you not adding it? I said, don't you think an author can die and he can keep an incomplete work behind, and that could be of significance? Because when we are reading somebody's book, this is my personal experience, like I'm reading somebody's a book written by somebody, I'm wanting to know that person more, because as we read more and more books by a single author, we come to know the author's habits, use of words, and we can almost forensically understand what the author is going to do in his next book or her next book.